Hello everyone. I'll be presenting some of the results from our research into electronic design automation for embedded systems. Specifically, we'll look at the results of exploring Monte Carlo tree search in the design of cross-layer reliability. This work was carried out during my postdoctoral research with the chair for process design at TU Dresden. So here's an outline of the talk. I'll briefly introduce the aspects that form the motivation for this work. We'll look at reliability, the need for cross-layer reliability, and the problem statement under study, which is cross-layer reliability integrated task mapping. We'll then take a look at the working principle of Monte Carlo tree search and the methods of design specification using MCTS that we have explored in this work. I'll briefly discuss the results from the experiments and then conclude with a summary and the scope for related future research. So reliability from an electronic design perspective is the ability of the system to function accordingly, according to the specifications, even in the presence of faults. When you say faults, we are broadly referring to two kinds of faults. So the transient faults occur randomly due to accumulation of electric charge and usually result in bad flips. Intermittent and permanent faults, on the other hand, are in general caused more due to aging and can result in both functional and timing failures. Although the physical phenomena behind these faults have existed for decades, the reduced masking and accelerated aging due to the technology scaling and other architectural innovations such as faster clock frequencies has meant that the operational lifetime of systems has in general reduced. Even during the operational lifetime, the systems are exhibiting more higher soft error rates. So the challenge is to adapt to these higher fault rates. One of the more advanced approaches to getting around this challenge is cross-layer reliability. The traditional approach to improving reliability has been more phenomena-based. This meant catering to each fault-causing mechanism, such as NBTI separately and mostly in hardware. While this does provide a clean abstraction to software developers, with the rising fault rates, this other layer agnostic approach may prove too costly, especially for resource constrained embedded systems. In contrast, the cross layer approach distributes the fault mitigation activities across multiple layers of the system stack. As a result, the implicit masking of multiple layers can be utilized. Also, it results in a more application specific approach. By utilizing different types of redundancies in the system. Such design decisions can be made to leverage the application's inherent robustness to degradation of certain types of reliability. However, designing with cross-layer reliability also increases the design space exploration complexity. Since cross-layer reliability increases the degrees of freedom for any system-level design process, the joint optimization across these degrees of freedom results in exponential growth of the design space. For instance, if we consider the problem of task mapping on HMP socks, cross-layer reliability introduces the additional design decisions of selecting and configuring the fault mitigation methods for each layer, and that too for every task in the application. These design decisions add to those already existing, for example, for selecting the processing element for each of the tasks and then scheduling the task in each of the processing elements. There have been several works related to designing cross-layer reliability for embedded systems. They include modeling and estimation of the resultant reliability due to a configuration which includes several fault mitigation methods. Similarly, there have been cross-layer works on design time DAC for task mapping and hardware-hardware partitioning, and also for dynamic adaptation. Across such related works, the focus has been on the design of fast estimation methods while integrating the effect of a combination of different redundancies. Similarly, the design space exploration focuses on generating efficient Pareto optimal design fronts that can be used effectively with a good runtime design space exploration. For instance, the figure here from one of our earlier works shows the improved Pareto front by using a joint optimization approach rather than combining the results from multiple single layer optimization runs. One major observation from the related works was the frequent use of multi-objective evolutionary algorithm based optimization techniques. In our current work, we have explored the possibility of reducing the redundant or wasted fitness evaluations for infeasible solutions, which usually occurs in multi-objective optimization with evolutionary algorithms, by using a more directed search method and trying to use Monte Carlo tree search for the same. Monte Carlo tree search is a heuristics-based tree traversal algorithm where the heuristics are obtained from Monte Carlo simulations of the design decisions. Here we can see the two more traditional exhaustive search methods, depth first search and width first search, and their exploration in finding the solution for a Sudoku problem. Comparatively, Monte Carlo tree search presents a more directed search in the sense that every new node that is explored is based on the quality of the nodes explored a priori, and the quality which has basically been estimated with Monte Carlo simulation of the design decisions. With Monte Carlo tree search, every new iteration starts from the root node, and the estimation results of any arbitrary node are backpropagated till the root node. Here we see the different Monte Carlo tree search based methods that were explored for the current work. We tested the performance of a constrained Monte Carlo tree search exploration compared to that of a pure problem agnostic approach. The problem agnostic Monte Carlo tree search did not integrate any constraints, any problem specific constraints, which, for example, in a current work could be the precedence of tasks while selecting the next design choice. For the constrained design space exploration, we integrated such constraints in the Monte Carlo tree search exploration. Similarly, we categorized the design decisions in cross-layer integrated task mapping into binding, scheduling, and cross-layer reliability configuration. A variation of exploration methods of these three types of design decisions was implemented for the comparison. The table here shows the resulting DAC methods, where the exploration of that particular design decision could be through Monte Carlo tree search or through genetic algorithms or through a list-based scheduling. Here we see the performance comparison of the constrained Monte Carlo tree search method over a pure MCTS for task mapping without considering any fault mitigation. The optimization is for minimizing the mix span in case of both fat and slim task graphs. In effect, more tasks in the application usually result in deeper search tree, while the maximum branching is determined by the maximum choices that are present at each level of the search tree. We observed that the more constrained Monte Carlo tree search performed better in deeper search trees, and we use that for the cross-layer reliability integrated task mapping experiments because that has a lot of design decisions which basically translate to a deeper search tree. For the reliability-aware task mapping, we considered the optimization of three different reliability metrics, mix span, error rate, and system MTTF, system mean time to failure. The design space exploration runs included optimizing for each of these metrics separately and also another run where the optimization of the equally weighted sum of the metrics was used as the objective. Here you see the results for the design space exploration runs for an application with nearly 100 tasks. We observed the combination of GN genetic algorithms and Monte Carlo tree search performing better in the optimization for mix span and system mean time to failure. For reducing the error rate, the combined approach provides results which is close to that of a purely genetic algorithm based design space exploration. To summarize, we presented the results for exploring the usage of Monte Carlo tree search for design space exploration problems with high complexity. We used cross-layer reliability integrated task mapping as the sample problem and explored a combination of multi-objective evolutionary algorithms and Monte Carlo tree search. We showed that the Monte Carlo tree search can be used to augment such evolutionary algorithm based methods such as genetic algorithms for such large design spaces. Thank you, and I'll take some questions for now.